Okay, suspensions and solutions and co-solvents. I had alluded to the concept of treating samples in a wet state or aqueous mode. And it's ideal to have solutions, of course. They're uniform, they're easy to reproduce. But if you can't get the solubility you want, you can work with suspensions. Now, since we're not really looking at kinetics and all that for forced degradation studies, you're more or less trying to just get things to degrade, suspensions really do have value. Samples, they should be sufficiently dispersed and wetted, and then you can leave it there to be stored. If a molecule is prone, trust me, something's going to happen, okay? Material that doesn't dissolve, you put it in base, it changes dramatically and fast. Co-solvents can aid for solubility. Some people use them. I really disfavor them because they change what is the native system. This slide I did get just from an online source. I see what the industry likes to use. It's a laundry list of things you can add. But again, caution, because it does change what's going on. And if, for example, any of these things would react with your component, well, then you've got a new issue. You don't really want those add-ins to affect the study in a negative way. Appearance is quite important. Everyone's been told that, right? So it matters too in stability. It's not just dealing with numbers and, you know, looking at a bunch of peaks. Our customers find value in our description of how samples look like after various treatments, because you never know down the line as you're looking at quality questions or even things like dissolution studies and drug product, how it's going to affect it. A stress treatment is going to affect the material. The important thing, though, is to keep mind of what does happen to a sample visually as well as numerically or chromatographically. One of the phenomena that can occur, and it's a very important, any drug developer, hence our customers, is this thing called deliquescence. Funny name that also can be synonymous with hygroscopicity. And as humidity increases in the environment, material will take up water so much that it might take up water and it will self-dissolve. This is actually a picture of sodium hydroxide. I bet everyone can relate to that on a humid day if you work with that, because the pellets start to look like they're liquefying. This is a very unideal trait for any drug substance.